Hey guys, today I'm going to be doing a Sav-A-Thread Heli-Coil repair on a Toro recycler lawn mower. Okay, we'll do the rest by hand here. There we go. Get all the chips. Alright, so let's inspect that a little closer. Okay, here we are. New threads. And that is just the thread for the Heli-Coil. That's not the spark plug thread. So next step, clean it out and then apply some RTV silicone to the Heli-Coil and screw it in flush, and we're almost there. All right, I'm gonna use this ultra gray rigid high torque RTV silicone for the threads. You have to put it on the threads before you screw it in. And it says it sets up in an hour and fully cures in 24 hours. And before I do that, I'm going to clean the head with brake cleaner. All right, I've got the silicone here. I'm gonna put a little bit around the threads. Now, if you notice, this has like little dimples or ridges or something, that this part with those little dimples have to be on the top. So we're going to insert it like this with these on the top. So I'm just going to put some of this around the threads. And it does say you could actually use the spark plug to help screw it in, but I'm going to see if I could do it without it. Then with my luck, I'll end up getting the spark plug, unscrewing it back out. So we'll get it started and see. Okay, there we go. Now it's kind of tough because you don't have a lot of room to work here, and I am going to get the spark plug here and put that in there and see. There we go. And it says to screw it in till it's flush. Looks like it wants to unscrew it. Oh, there we go. Alright, we'll finish it off by hand, I guess. Looks like most of that RTV silicone is just coming back out. It's probably way too much. Let's get it going a little bit more. It's not quite flush. I guess I'm gonna use the spark plug again to try to get it in a little bit more. All right, that looks pretty good. Nice and flush. Let's flip it over and take a look, see what it looks like from the inside. There it is from the inside. And looks good. So, alright, so next I'm going to get the expanding tool, and you got to hit it several times with a hammer. But it says do not hit too hard. This is the expanding tool. So I guess you just kind of put it right in there. Give it one more little whack. All right, looks like that should do it. So we're going to let that dry, and then we'll reinstall it on the mower. All right, it's all dried up, and we're ready to reinstall the head on the engine. All right, here's the new head gasket. Since I'm reassembling it here in an awkward position to get it on tape, I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to put the gasket here on the back side of the head, put the bolts through, and then put it on. All right. So it obviously goes on like this. We'll just start one in this corner, and maybe this one here. Here we go. Now I'll get my ratchet and get them all started. All right, now you're supposed to torque this down to 128 inch-pounds, or you could divide that by 12 for the foot-pounds of torque with a torque wrench. That's the specs for these head bolts. The truth is, I don't have a torque wrench, so I'm just going to have to do it by feel and hope for the best. Now you have to kind of do a crisscross pattern, you know, when you tighten these down, because you don't want to put uneven pressure. So I'm going to start up here, give it a little bit of a turn, come down here, a little bit of turn. And see, that side was tighter. The top, this corner, felt a little looser. Go in the middle. All right, got the head all tightened down. I'm going to put the plug in. That tighten down. There we go. Don't need to go crazy with that. And now it's time to reassemble all the covers. I won't bore you with that. And we'll do a test run. I already topped it off with oil. The thing was empty. It takes 20 ounces of oil. I'm gonna put some fresh gas in it. That can't, or the tank is completely empty. Put the spark plug wire on, and we'll see how she runs. All right, just gonna put enough gas in here to get her going. All right, the tank was completely empty, so we're gonna prime it here a bunch of times. Idle seems a little low, but I don't know what it was really running like previously. That might be its normal full running speed. I don't see any throttle control on it. All right, we're gonna give her a little test mow and see how she works.
Well, guys, she seems to be working great. I'm sure my brother's going to be real happy with it. And as soon as he gets back from vacation, I'm going to surprise him with it. So thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.